TNTM The Show presents...
Talking Nerdy, March 2024.
Invincible Season 2 Part 2 is out. There's been a couple episodes, so we'll talk about those. With your hosts, Pablo Gunner.
The Ambassador.
And our guest.
Special guest.
Oh, Marvin Goof here.
Marvin Goof, yes, who did a Dune 2. He did our... Dune 2 review, Dune Part 2 review to be more specific. And so we are here to talk nerdy to you. We've been doing this, what, like almost 13 years now?
Yeah.
Right? Crazy. So we are here to waste our time so you don't have to, right? Like we're going to watch everything good or bad that's nerdy, you know, try to play as many things, do as many things so you don't waste your time. You can save it for the best of the best,
absolutely,
right?
Yeah.
So that's what we're here to deliver on. Invincible. Invincible's back. We have a season two, part two. And I don't know if they put like two episodes out right away because it felt really long, but it felt like a smooth, easy view, right?
Yeah.
Because he's like, it takes a little place after the previous season where his dad is gone. Like, the Viltrumites took him, and they're like, hey, now you're the new Viltrumite that's supposed to watch over Earth. Like, he's gonna do what they say. Like, I don't know, like, what they were thinking. Like, yeah, sure, I'm gonna just do what
well,
you guys said.
We know in an alternate world he does.
Yeah, in an alternate universe, he actually does a lot of times, like, side with his dad. So, but anyways, so yeah, but that was really interesting, just that interaction with, like, his stepmom, you might call her? Which
yeah.
is the insect lady, and she's just talking about how, like...
Their lives are a lot shorter.
They're a lot shorter, so they don't really bother with, like, you know, holding grudges. They just move on. They just move forward, right?
Mm.
And so there's a baby, and he's half, like, insectoid and half Viltrumite. And so she's like, hey, we're gonna die, and he's not gonna have a mother, so will you take him? And you're like, wow, this is crazy. And then so now, like, his mom's taking care of his dad's...
Other kid.
Yeah, yeah, like, wow. It is all kinds of messed up, and it's just crazy.
And you can't take the kid out in public because the kid's got, like,
he's
purple skin.
Yeah, he looks like Purple Man.
But he looks like the main character, younger version of the main character.
Yeah.
Because the dad's traits really pushed on, which makes sense for Viltrumites. Because Viltrumites tend to take over even their biology.
Yeah.
So, like, when they mix with humanoid creatures, a lot of times their offspring ends up being more powerful than...
Potentially Viltrumites.
Than the original race.
Yeah.
It's pretty crazy.
Okay. I mean, admittedly, I'm here, and I haven't seen a lot of it. This sounds really interesting.
Well, I love the idea of Invincible just because, to me, it's like a what-if of Dragon Ball Z... mixed with Superman and other, like, comics. Because it's like, Viltrumites are essentially Saiyans, but it's like, if the Saiyans actually did take over, were like, they weren't conquered by Frieza, and they just did take over everything, you know? Mm. And that's what they do, is they send people out to just take over.
Daleks!
You will be!
And then, so this is like, if Gohan was... to fight his dad, you know, and the race of the Saiyans, kind of. But then, like, his dad is also, like, the Superman of... And then there's other superheroes, too. So, like... And you can obviously tell, like, who's a ripoff of, like, Martian Manhunter, you know, and Superman. And
the freaking...
The Flash,
the Aquaman one was just too funny.
Yeah, the Aquaman's hilarious because they just go crazy with it.
They're like, this guy's a freaking fish.
Yeah, like, it's literally just looks like a Magikarp head and then a human body. And you're like, what? So,
I approve of this.
But, yeah, dude, the thing is, it is brutal. Like, it's messed up. It's brutal. It's gory.
Smurge Billy.
Like, if you are not used to it, like, it's really kind of rough to watch because it is brutal.
Just watch the first episode, and the last scene of the first episode gives you an idea of what the series will be like. Because the first, I'm not going to say what it is because it's just too good, but the last scene, it's just the biggest WTF you'll ever see.
But yeah, so, and the new, there's also, like, so they have New Guardians, which are essentially, like, the, you know, Justice League. And this one is they're going with the story of like essentially the Martians, and they look like Martians from like the Manhunter, you know, mm-hmm. from, and they're doing essentially Starro. It's essentially Starro, or mm-hmm. you know, is what it is. That's what they're doing.
Okay.
But like I said, to a whole different like messed up level, and it's interesting, and it's really awesome, and I totally dig it, and it's a good time.
Yeah, and pseudo love interest is such an interesting character, Eve.
Oh yeah, Eve is awesome.
She's just crazy. Like the power she has is just insane.
Well, I better get on this thing then.
Oh yeah,
It just feels bored. I've heard so many things because of the brutality. That's I'm like, okay. Let's just see how brutal this gets.
Yeah, but they have J.K. Simmons voicing Omni-Man,
mm-hmm.
and it's just so perfect, and that he portrays it so well.
Oh yeah.
And then they have Steven Yeun, the kid,
mm-hmm.
and Steven Yeun really blows out of the water, because he's an actor I have mixed feelings with. Because I've watched The Walking Dead, hence the mixed feelings.
Oh, he wasn't bad in it, though. He was good.
He wasn't.
That show was just...
The writing was bad. He was portraying it to the best of his ability, but it's still...
Because he's done a lot of good work, actually. Like, he does a lot of good voice work. He was in Voltron as well.
Yeah.
And he's in a lot of his movies and shows have been really, really great. But yeah, for me, it's a must-see. Like, you definitely have to get on it. I mean, you might want to wait. If you're the kind of person that prefers to binge, wait, because they're doing the weekly thing. It can be annoying. I think for this show specifically, I think it is annoying. Like, I don't like doing the weekly thing for this show specifically. Because they do leave, like, these cliffhangers, and you're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to have to wait. But yeah, it's been pretty great, pretty gruesome, and pretty great. So yeah, for me, it's a must see.
It's a must watch.
Must stream on Amazon Prime. So that's that. And that being said, like I said, we talked about some of our merch already, of the stuff we're going to be making for you all for next month. I'm sporting our Dragon Ball style shirt, Talk Nerdy to Me, because of course, if you've heard, Akira Toriyama passed away, which is such an icon, such a legend. His, of course, Dragon Ball, but
he also did like Chrono Trigger, and then he did Dragon Quest games.
Yes, so he's just like, it's so crazy when people go, all he did was put pen to paper, and how much, right? Like drawing and writing, and how much people did he affect? There is a generation of nerds, because there's nerds used to be basement dwellers, you know, attic dwellers maybe. Now look what they are. They're the gun show, right? Like,
yes.
and I'm not even one of the big ones. Like, there's dudes that legitimately look like Broly, mm-hmm. because of Dragon Ball Z. There's dudes that look like Goku. Like, there's a generation, and then, like, even like you said, the other stuff, like, that he's done, it's just crazy how he's changed, you know, he's changed, obviously, even America, the Americas, Western civilization, because I know that Dragon Ball Z is massive in South America even, right? Because
yep,
they came, they were there before they were in the States. So, like, they're huge. It's huge everywhere. And it's so crazy, the influence of the guy just made drawings and wrote some stuff. And that's it. And it's beautiful, beautiful.
Indeed.
So if you want to do it, do it. Be inspired by that. And let's make those stories, right?
Absolutely.
And inspire people to work out, to do more, to grow, to be better. So, yeah. And then I also got my... Azul Beetle pants that I designed. I don't even know if I have these in the store, but I just loved the Blue Beetle movie so much. It spoke to me. I know it didn't speak to everybody. It wasn't really necessarily meant to speak to everybody. I mean, hopefully it does to us and then to a certain degree, but I thought it was phenomenal. I think it was one of the best things, if not the best thing, that DC's put out in a long time. So, especially if you're not, like, into superhero stuff, I think, like, you won't notice a lot of the things, I won't say ripped off, but definitely, you know, we're taking notes from, like, Iron Man, and mm-hmm. I mean, there's so much, right? There's so much now.
Yeah.
But, yeah. What about you guys?
Well, I mean, that pretty much sums it up for me. there's a lot of good stuff coming out, you know, so...
But you got the Halo.
I did get the Halo shirt right here, so, you know.
And we're going to have to hook him up with the Star Trek, you know.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
We'll get that Star Trek merch out there. We don't have much now, but like I said, we'll start pumping it out. Yeah, so for sure.
They might just all forget about Star Trek, like how everyone conveniently forgot about Michael in Discovery. That was the dumbest thing I've ever seen in my life. Basically, Michael Burnham, the main character, when they go into the future, they're like, okay, well, we're all going to forget about this character.
That's all interesting.
That was really, like, literally what they said. It was bad.
Oh, man.
I'll have to check it out.
Yeah.
I love the main chick, though. Oh, my gosh. Wasn't she also in Walking Dead?
Maybe.
Yeah, she was in Walking Dead. But, I mean, I love the first season. I absolutely love the first season of Star Trek Discovery. So, and I know there's other stuff that's been really good I've heard of Star Trek that's out there. What's the other one that they have besides Discovery? I know there's Picard, obviously, which I've heard both good and bad things, but mostly good. Beyond, that's the other one.
Brave New World is out there, but Brave New Worlds is out there somewhere, too.
Not Beyond,
Stranger Worlds.
Stranger Worlds, that's the one I've heard a lot of good things about.
That one's been kind of good.
Even Lower Decks.
Basically, happens before Kirk takes over the Enterprise, and so it's... focused on Pike's turn as captain.
Okay, sweet. So, and then you're rocking the...
Talk Nerdy to Me Star Wars shirt.
Yes, and this is like our first, one of our first shirts, right? Like, our stuff's gotten way better. Like, we've added, like, light swords. Are we, you know?
Beam swords,
you know? But yeah, like, there's some legit stuff. Like, we have, like... You know, the double one, the white ones. Like, we have so many different designs that Slay J designed that are just phenomenal. And I feel like I need to get those ones because they're so great.
Yes.
But, yeah, there's so much stuff. So, and what's great, too, is so every month we donate 5% of our profits to charity. So, help us help them by buying our merch. Mm-hmm. For March, it's Center for Reproductive Rights. Last month it was Noble. I forget. I know that for April we're going to do Autism Speaks. Mm-hmm. So I've done my research. That's what we're going to cover. That's going to be charity that we're going to be donating to. So please help us so that we can help them out, right? We want to make a positive influence on our society, on our world,
absolutely,
you know?
Absolutely, yes.
And that being said, I want to give shout outs because the people that have positively helped us as well. Of course, at the top of that list, and always at the top of that list, we have to give out a shout out to our best bud Atticus, who just continues to grow and get better and do more interesting things on his YouTube channel as a YouTuber in Vietnam, as a teacher in Vietnam, and just showing us, you know, slice of life, you know, anything goes. Like, I mean, now he's done a deep dive of Dune on his, so he has nerdy stuff too. Like, we've inspired him to do some nerdy stuff on his channel. So definitely check him out. He's one of the greatest. We have Burn Akenshin, the superpower list. Check them out on Facebook and definitely on X. We also added, there's Gone Gold Podcast, Po' Boy Pod, Billy D's, G-Mart 8, Pesky Gremlins. They retweet us a lot, so they're awesome. Cinematic Anarchy, Filmmaker Pod, MK Jekyll and Hyde. They're across the board. They do online web comics and stuff.
Nice.
And I just love the message that they send. Like, everything that they say is so inspirational. Mm. So definitely check them out. The Film Rage guys, those guys, they review every single movie, good or bad, kind of like us. Mm-hmm. They waste their time, so you don't have to. And some stuff is surprising. You'll be surprised. Like, some stuff you're like, oh, I thought that was going to be garbage. They give just enough to where it doesn't feel like completely spoiled, but they'll spoil if they're like, we're going to spoil so that you don't waste your time because you shouldn't. Like, we have to spoil it so that you... You know, do that. So they're great. Web Imagine Service, they do music and promote music. Amerime Media, they're similar to us, but they're different. And Riot TV, they do streaming stuff, which is hilarious. Zarin67. And then newly added, is G-Nuts of Horror. So if you're into horror, definitely check them out because they do reviews for stuff for them. So that's where you're going to get your horror stuff. Like, comment, subscribe, share us, you know, with your friends, your family, your dogs, you know, your pets, whatever.
Let's talk. Let's keep talking about this stuff.
We're trying to get to 500 subscribers. We're more than halfway there so that we can cover more stuff for you. And like I said, like us on Facebook and help us out. You know, we really appreciate it. We love it. Thank you for getting where you've gotten us to now on everything. We're on everything. We're on X. We're on the threads. We're on Instagram. We're on Facebook. We're on YouTube, of course. So talk nerdy to me.
Stay nerdy, Planet Earth.